God was Jenny spanning 3 years in the life of each of our graduates to train the professional status that they will proudly walk away with today. As I promised Your Excellency and the nation at the last graduation ceremony on October 31st, 2014, this year has been dedicated to resource mobilization. Allow me to cite Kwame Nkrumah's pronouncement way back on 26th March 1965, not only to the National Assembly in Ghana, but also to Africa as a whole. And I quote, "We have the blessing of the wealth of our vast resources, the power of our talents, and the potentialities of our people. Let us grasp now the opportunities before us and meet the challenge to our survival." Nkrumah's call, Your Excellency, in Charleston clearly reflects the spirit in which we work here at Great Zimbabwe University. We acknowledge that our resources are vast, but that most of our resources are intellectual. I believe that nothing beats imagination and creativity. Hence, we tap fully into the power of our talents and the potentialities of our people. Your Excellency, despite how shaken we are and pale with worry we are due to our current economic environment, let us, as a nation, take advantage of this moment of peace to catch our breath, and as we pant, map out a trajectory for the survival of the economy and the nation at large. Indeed, Your Excellency, despite the gloomy cloud that continues to loom over our economy, the future of Zimbabwe is bright, and I repeat, bright. For those like ourselves who use the present to prepare for the future, the time is now. We have embraced every opportunity for resource mobilization that has come our way, and we've run away with it. Allow me, Your Excellency, to share with you some of the strides we have made in the area of resource mobilization. Let me begin by stating that the term resource does not mean just money. No, that would be a tragic and unfortunate narrowing down of the essence of the term. Allow me, Your Excellency, to give an outline of what we have done in the area of resource mobilization. Firstly, under the wise and shrewd leadership of our Chairman of Council, Mr. Simbisa Tshiambakwe, and his vibrant council, and in full cognizance of the need to grow this university, in order to cater adequately for an ever-growing student body, Great Zimbabwe University, the university of choice, purchased a brick-making molding machine currently producing 7,000 bricks per day, 35,000 bricks per week, and about 140,000 bricks per month. As a result, we are producing most of the bricks we need for our construction projects. We are also able to sell bricks to our staff and the Masuku community at a reasonable price. The purchase of a brick molding machine was also inspired by the need to provide a conducive environment for the development of an invaluable human resource base for the nation in our pursuit of high quality educational excellence. Secondly, we have fully commercialized the university farm. We now cater for the entire requirements of the university's cafeteria in terms of the provision of beef, poultry, and eggs. We have a thriving poultry project that produces 10,000 table birds per month. Further to this, we are now supplying live and professionally packaged dressed chickens for sale to the Masuku community. In addition, Your Excellency, we have opened up 25,000 hectares of land for this summer's cropping season, and a further 3,000 have been put under citrus production. Your Excellency and Chancellor, allow me at this point to talk about a key area of institutional enhancement, which is that of infrastructural development. Although we have not been able to put up the anticipated university buildings at the next to Holy Shrine, we have not been sitting and doing nothing. We do, however, bear with government and treasury as they try, and quite sincerely so, to find funds for the construction of the university at this mandated place. Your Excellency, I'm only too willing to advise this congregation that we are critically aware of the need to grow the university to produce the critical human capital needed for the development of the nation, the region, and the world. Your Excellency and Chancellor, we have continued to enjoy goodwill amongst the banking and private sectors of the nation in the form of pretty munificent donations and public-private partnerships. To mention a few of these, we have received a generous donation from Heritage Insurance Company, which comes in the form of a bus that you see outside there and an ambulance for student use. We will humbly request Your Excellency on your way from this podium to kindly commission this bus and ambulance. We are walking this journey not alone, but with committed friends. ZB Bank is coming to rehabilitate sporting facilities for the physical well-being of our staff and students. CBZ has also joined us by equipping our student medical health centers, including the soon-to-be-opened Kucheke Clinic. This facility was previously owned by the late true son of Zimbabwe, Dr. Simon Mazowazi. The university acquired and refurbished it for the benefit of the Mcheke community. We will shortly be requesting our Minister, Your Excellency, to hand over this facility to his colleague, the Minister of Health, so that the people of Masingo can find a refuge and comfort in it. We are a university with a soul. Allow me, Your Excellency and Chancellor, ladies and gentlemen, to catalogue some of our outstanding achievements in the year under review. These achievements have given us reason to celebrate. We have continued and abetted in our drive for institutional and infrastructural development. At the center of our consciousness is the need for us to continuously improve student and staff welfare. Key in this area is the need for student residences. In light of this, we have entered into a partnership with a local bank for the construction of student residences on land donated to us by Masingo City Council at our Mcheke campus. The project is expected to be completed by the end of next year. We secured the former FABS building in the city, refurbished it, and made it an extension of our growing School of Gender and Cultural Studies. We also completed the construction of the School of Social Sciences in the industrial area and installed some of the latest technology yet to be seen in our other universities. A state-of-the-art computer lab was completed and set up with the assistance of the Nairobi-based Africa Virtual University. They are currently setting up our conference facilities here to allow us to receive and fly live lectures from some of our renowned African virtual universities. I recall briefly reporting to you yesterday, as I had the privilege of sitting next to you in your office, Your Excellency, which not so many people here will have the opportunity to, that now our student in Mashaba who has missed this bus and can't join the lecture in social sciences can, as long as he or she is paid up, access his or her laptop and follow a live lecture taking place in Mashallah. Ah, Tato Alem Berin Beri says, Arena Rata. We extended the City Campus Library and increased its sitting capacity from 350 to 500 at a time. We also completed the Mashallah Campus Library, which is now open. At this point, allow me, Your Excellency, to appreciate the significant donation of computers made by the Minister of Higher and Tertiary Education, Professor Jonathan Moyo, during his visit to this university. He was so taken up by the developments in the university that he graciously made donations. I doubt he made elsewhere. In our pursuit to improve staff welfare, particularly the working environment for our staff, we have acquired more office teaching and learning space in the city, all wired up with fast broadband and internet services, and well equipped with water and backup electricity services. It is my hope that this continued development will inspire our staff to develop quality lecture materials and to research feverishly as we seek to improve our teaching. Your Excellency, we have acquired 5 more vehicles for use by our directors and those of departments, and 6 additional vehicles for use by our work-related department. Your Excellency, the digital age is giving an opportunity for educational institutions to optimize the use of technology, such as online collaborative services. Hence, in the area of information communication technologies, we have introduced some astonishing developments. We have engaged international partners. We have started working on a biometric access system and smart card system, which will be used in the canteen, in the library, in examinations, and student residences, and to gain access to all other university-wide facilities. We managed to install state-of-the-art Aruba wireless system at the School of Social Sciences in Mashaba. We want to express our sincere gratitude to our partners, Tel-1, who are coming in to provide equipment and expertise for students' Wi-Fi access. During the period under review, we managed to install world-class teaching and learning equipment comprising of smart interactive projectors and public address systems in order to enhance our teaching and learning experience, resulting in our students being exposed to the latest technology in education. To enhance adoption of new technology by our teaching staff, we held training workshops for our staff on the use of these Moodle e-learning system, as well as anti-plagiarism software, both of which improve the quality of our graduates. It is now virtually difficult or impossible, Your Excellency, for our students to plagiarize assignments, because we quickly send the assignments to Turnitin, and in a matter of minutes, the assignment comes back with all the plagiarized parts in red. Watch out, the time for plagiarizing is over. Your Excellency, please allow me to now talk about the critical issue of university mandate and to provide an overview of how we have embraced our niche as a university, a niche which I consider to be the most relevant to the nation's immediate need for socioeconomic development, that of arts, culture and heritage studies and preservation. Your Excellency, we have remained fully conscious of our niche as a university, and let me assure you that our niche has been and remains our driving force. Allow me to take you through the ways in which we have infused our niche into virtually every vein of the university's life. We have fully operationalized the teaching of university-wide modules with an infusion of indigenous knowledge systems. These are the modules through which the mandate of the university is distilled. The university-wide modules, which include introduction to Zimbabwean culture and heritage, Zimbabwean history, and African philosophy and thought, instill Ubuntu in our graduates. Your Excellency, because we are an institution of culture and heritage, we have taken the university to the custodians of the nation's culture and heritage. In this regard, I'm pleased to announce that the Great Zimbabwe University, Herbert Stapel Law School, has teamed up with the Zimbabwe Chiefs Council to set up a steering committee to spearhead the compilation of a basic law syllabus to provide legal studies to all the nation's 272 traditional leaders who are key in the nation's judicial system. It is hoped that this development will improve justice delivery, especially in the rural areas where our chiefs preside over primary courts. Your Excellency and Chancellor, further to the university's efforts of mainstreaming its niche and leading to the legacy of its mandate, Great Zimbabwe University has, through Senate and the approval of Council, renamed its faculties and critical centers. Further to the Herbert Stapel Law School, which was officially commissioned by none other than Your Excellency, I'm proud to announce the following. The Gary Magazine School of Agriculture and Natural Sciences, renamed after the late Gary Magazine, who was a strong serving Zimbabwe National Farmers Union president and was declared a national hero for his contribution to agriculture. The Joshua Mukwabuko Nkomo School of Arts and Humanities. This school has been named in remembrance of Comrade Joshua Nkomo, who was the vice president of Zimbabwe and who helped in uniting Zimbabweans from different cultural backgrounds. Simon Welisai Muzenda School of Culture and Heritage Studies has been named after the late vice president of Zimbabwe who actively promoted culture. Monumutapa School of Commerce has been named after Monumutapa, who established a World Trade Center which linked Zimbabwe with Asia, Europe, and the Arab world. With assistance, let me say how proud we are to instill in our students the sense of being African, the sense of being who we are. With assistance of our parent ministers, Department of Manpower, Training and Department, we are currently constructing the iconic Robert Mugabe School of Education, which will be like no other in the region. To celebrate God's gift of excellency to this nation. Education is your passion, and we have made it our responsibility to turn that passion into visible reality. We continue to live your dream and to work with you as we strive to develop the country's human capital base. I thank you for that. The School of Social Sciences has been named the Julius Nyerere School of Social Sciences after the famed Pan-Africanist and long-serving chairman of the Frontline States. The name will serve to continuously remind us that we owe our freedom to the support of the founding fathers of the African Union, and that we exist, suffer the challenges, and prosper in fraternal partnership with the rest of Africa. The Bernard Shapiro Graduate School of Business owes its new name to the renowned economist, former finance minister, and national hero, Dr. Shapiro. The centers are as follows. The Kwame Nkrumah Center for African and Asian Studies, named after the luminary and famed Pan-Africanist, the advocate of African unity, and former president of Ghana. Buyane Handa Center for Gender and Cultural Studies, named after the celebrated female leader Thank you. Of the first Chimurenga, through whom the value and essence of African womanhood was first realized. Your Excellency and Chancellor, in all our projects within the city, we have enjoyed the ardent support of Council. Allow me at this juncture, Your Excellency, to pay special homage and gratitude to the town clerk, Mr. Kusha. He has been at the forefront of our projects. He has assisted us in growing the institution and has indeed become a critical cog in the execution of our agenda. Allow me to, Your Excellency, to advise this congregation that members of Gladysburg University teaching staff were invited by the Ministry of Primary and Secondary Education to participate in the curriculum review for primary and secondary education. Us and culture and heritage were factored in as cross-cutting themes in all the subjects from early childhood to A-level. The whole idea was to indigenize the curriculum in the same fashion as Gladysburg University curriculum. Culture and heritage studies has become an independent subject of study. There are prospects of the said ministry eliciting upon Gladysburg University staff and giving them the responsibility to produce teachers with the expertise to teach culture and heritage for purposes of advancing the ZIM asset agenda. I can confidently say that I enjoy the support of the minister with whom I was driving this morning. Your Excellency and Chancellor, only 2 months ago, your successor to the chairmanship of Southern African Development Community SADC, His Excellency President Lieutenant General Seretse Ian Kamo Botswana, admitted in his inaugural acceptance speech of the chairman of SADC at the 35th SADC Summit at the Gaborone International Conference Center in Botswana on August 17th this year, that the industrialization agenda in Africa was Your Excellency's brainchild. President Kama also revealed that it was your idea to embark on the revised regional indicative strategic development plan 2015 to 2020, which the extraordinary summit held in Harare in April this year adopted. Rightfully so, Your Excellency enunciated the ZIM asset program for this nation from a well-informed position, guided by experience, a clear vision and passion for the economic turnaround of the nation. And those of us who don't believe that this nation is the future, I challenge you to come back home and think like an African, and think like a Zimbabwean. When Your Excellency and Chancellor took over from Malawi as the SADC chairman, the bloc adopted the theme SADC Strategy for Economic Transformation, leveraging the region's diverse resources for sustainable economic and social development through beneficiation and value addition. The success of this strategy for SADC and for the nation, in your own words, Your Excellency, and I quote, lies in the acceptance that people should always be at the center of all programs, and women and youth are the backbone of the economy, close quote. Your Excellency and Chancellor, as a university, we share in your vision that the adoption of the regional development blueprint, the SADC revised indicative strategic development plan 2015 to 2020, mainstreaming industrial development into the master plan, and prioritization of the industrial pillar will enhance regional integration. Your Excellency, Great Zimbabwe University has the most important and most relevant mandate among all higher and tertiary education institutions for the achievement of your vision. It is no coincidence, therefore, that Great Zimbabwe University is mandated with this colossal task in the reclamation of our arts, culture, and heritage. We have been aware of this from the very beginning, and we have tried to occupy our space since October 2012 by taking our responsibility seriously. Great Zimbabwe University has become the university of choice, not only in Zimbabwe, but in the region and beyond. And indeed, all other budding universities are being continuously directed by ministry to come and see how our university has grown here. We receive them with humility and walk them through the process. And those that will take a leaf from our page are assured growth along the same lines. Great Zimbabwe University continues to chart a path of growth as required both by yourself and by our sister ministry. Furthermore, other countries have come on board to request the expert services of Great Zimbabwe University for the capacitation of their human resources. I refer here to the Education Minister of Namibia and Swaziland, who have approached us for assistance in the training of their teachers in special needs education and a few other programs. I also take the opportunity and pleasure of announcing Great Zimbabwe University's establishment of its Swaziland Manzini campus for special needs education. During this holiday, our lecturers were there training their people for this very important task. The first intake of this campus will sit for institutional examinations together with the rest of our students next month here. Your Excellency and Chancellor, we are particularly excited by the well-calculated creation of the critical new ministry just last month on the 12th of September 2015. This is the Ministry of Rural Development, Preservation and Promotion of Culture and Heritage, headed by Honorable Minister Abed Nigumbube. It's a very welcome development that we, together with the stakeholders in the cultural industry, the myriad of cultural practitioners, performers and producers nationwide, are celebrating. Indeed, this is a development that comes in the wake of national awareness campaigns for the importance of the preservation of cultural, tangible, and intangible heritage. Your Excellency and Chancellor, I pledge Great Zimbabwe University's commitment to partner with this new ministry and provide full participation and consultancy for its programs. It is my sincere hope that the creation of this ministry will translate into the overdue birth of a national cultural policy that has been held in abeyance for so long. The groundwork has already been done. Zimbabwe has the knowledge, skills, and expertise tapped from the legacy of nationalist consciousness leadership, which is your own, as well as from extraterritorial policies that Zimbabwe has signed and ratified. This includes, Your Excellency, the AU Cultural Charter for Africa, 1976, prior to independence, the Protection of Underwater Cultural Heritage, 2001, Protection of the World and Cultural and Natural Heritage, 1972, Fighting Against Illicit Trafficking of Cultural Property, 1970, Protection of Cultural Property in the Event of Armed Conflict, goes back to 1954, Protection